Well, now let's take a look at example number two and see if we can try to do the exact same thing. Can we determine what type of conic section is represented by this particular equation? Well, again, it's going to be helpful for me to try to complete the square. I would ask you right now to try to pause the video and see if you can attempt to complete the square on your own, and when you hit unpause, you'll be able to see me work through the solution. So if I'm going to go ahead and complete the square here, I know that I can take my 9x squared minus my 45x, and I know I'm going to add something to that. I'll put all my y's on the same side over here, so I'll do my 25 y squareds plus 50 y's plus something, and I'll put 119 on the other side because I moved the 19 over. If I pull this out, pull out my 25, I think it becomes pretty easy to see what I need to go ahead and add in for each of these. In the first one, I need to add in a 9. In the second one, I need to add in a 1. Don't forget, though, to distribute, so I need to counterbalance with an 81 and with a 25. So this turns into 9 times x minus 3 squared, 25 times y plus 1 squared, and on this side I get, I think it's 225. Now, if I was to go ahead and simplify this down, dividing everything by 225, I get x minus 3 squared over 25. I get y plus 1 squared over 9, and this is equal to 1. So here's the process of completing the square totally done, and it looks like I have the shape of an ellipse. Great. So again, I can go here and establish a couple things. This is an ellipse that's going to have a center at 3, negative 1. I can see the shifts in each coordinate. And I can also see the value of A, which is under here, is going to be 5. And the value of B is going to be 3. So I can see there's more shift in the x direction, less shift in the y direction. If I was to then go ahead and create a picture for this, I can see that I'm going to start at the center of 3, negative 1. Let's suppose that that's right here. I'm going to shift horizontally 5 units, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to shift 5 units back. I'm going to shift 3 units down and 3 units up. And here's now a sketch of my ellipse. I just have to make sure that I connect these dots with as smooth of a curve as I'm capable of. And again, it's a rough sketch, so if your picture looks horrible, possibly even worse than mine right now, that's totally fine. Boom, there's a rough sketch of the ellipse. I got it.